Good morning, bro. Men to the left because women are always right. I remember the first time I saw that message. It was in this like kind of artsy little restaurant in actually the city I live in currently. And I remember thinking to myself, I was like, you know, that's kind of funny. I kind of fuck with that. That's kind of a, you know, that's quite a like a sexist joke. It's kind of funny, you know. I was like, well, that's a smart one, you know. That kind of got me like, yeah, fuck you guys, but yeah, that's kind of funny. And then I went back to that same restaurant another 3 or 4 times, and I remember thinking to myself each time I went to the bathroom in that restaurant, I was like, yeah, it was funny the first time I read it, but it's kind of getting in my head. It's kind of actually playing on my mind a little bit. It's kind of actually making me slightly resentful. And I don't know why. And maybe I'm the problem. But why am I almost kind of starting to believe this? Now, straight away, there'll be some comments saying, it's just a joke. You're the problem if you think this is serious. And hey, you could be dead right. And I don't want to say that I am right in this instance, because honestly, I don't know. However, I do want to give my opinion on this whole feminist movement and feminist agenda that has become undeniably widespread among the world, but especially I've seen it more and more in my home country, in Ireland. And I'm going to talk about the thumbnail specifically, because where I took that photo is basically, it's the entrance to one of the only public toilet areas in Galway City, which is the city I live in. And so basically there's one shopping center in Galway, one main shopping center. Like there's maybe 2 or 3 kind of small ones, and then there's one pretty, well, it's not even big, it's quite small, but it's like, it's considered the main shopping center in Galway City. And in that shopping center are the, as far as I know, they're kind of like the only public toilets where you can just walk into them without having to say buy something in a shop. Like, as in, there's obviously public toilets in say McDonald's or Supermax or anywhere like that. However, you're kind of expected to buy something in those places before you go to the toilet, whereas these toilets are like the main public toilets. And I remember walking into that bathroom, this is just maybe a week ago now, and all of a sudden I saw that and I was like, holy shit, this actually isn't really a joke anymore. This has kind of actually become widespread messaging. And I'm going to come at it from a different angle today than you might expect. I'd say there might be some people watching this video who are expecting me to come at it from the like alpha red pill. No, women are always wrong. Women are dumb hoes and women should be in the kitchen and all this kind of thing. I personally am not a believer in that whole message. I'm not like one of these red pill weirdos who's like, I have to be the more dominant one in the relationship. I have to hold my masculine frame. I'm not really like that, to be honest. I'm a lot more flexible and a lot more like just understanding of human nature in general than that. However, I cannot deny any longer that this is becoming a problem. And I will explain exactly why. Because, as I mentioned at the start of this video, when I first saw that message, I was 11 years old. I literally remember what age I was, because it was around the time where I was like, I was just kind of starting to get starting to get out into the big bad world and starting to like actually consider things like, oh, wow, there is actually different jobs out there for different kinds of people, and there are actually people who get married and get divorced, and there's like, you know, you start learning about like the world on a higher level than your small mind when you're like 10 and you're like, oh, so the world is just like having fun and painting and the taxes and stuff, like all the adult stuff is just for the adults. But around the age of 11 is when I first started being like, oh shit, so there are actually complex issues and topics and things going on in the world. And I remember seeing that exact same message, or that exact same like quote, which is, men to the left because women are always right. And as I said at the start of this video, at first I found it quite funny. I was like, yeah, that's kind of funny, like. But the more and more I saw it, the more I was like, why do I feel as though there's a hint of passive aggression underneath this? And why do I feel as though this is actually kind of demeaning towards me as a very, very young man when I was 11 years old? But it's spread so much. It has spread, like, it's almost in every bathroom that you go to, in like the public arena nowadays. If you walk into a public bathroom, chances are there's going to be that quote, men to the left because women are always right. And now it is, when you view it like surface level, and when you just look at it and you're like, okay, that's just literally words on a wall, it's not that deep. It's not that deep. I completely agree with that. However, when you think about it, when you actually deep it, you realize, you're like, holy shit, hold on a minute. This has become such widespread conditioning messaging that is actually impacting people. Like, think about it. When I was 11 years old, yes, I found it funny, but the more I saw it over the few months after that, when I went to the restaurant, the more I was like, this is kind of starting to piss me off. I'm starting to get a little bit resentful. But imagine nowadays. Nowadays, it's not just one little cute little artsy restaurant like on the, you know, the outskirts of the town that people don't really go to. This is in the public bathroom in my city. Like, this is the messaging in my city. You never see anything where it's like, men are good and strong and they sacrifice a lot to help the people they love and they care about. It's always like degrading and demeaning towards men. It is pop culture nowadays to be offensive and be degrading and be demeaning towards men. And that's fucked. Like, that is fucked. I'll be honest, I think that's really fucked up. And it's happening in a time where it's so interesting, the time it's happening in, because I remember a few years ago, maybe 2 or 3 years ago, almost every single girl I knew, every single girl I spoke to back in the day, used to be on the, you know, like, I'm a strong, independent woman who doesn't need any man in her life, and I do things myself and all that. And I was kind of like, yo, like, if that's you, cool, go do that. Like, that's your life, live it. But now, speaking to those same women in 2024, so many of them have changed their tune, where they're like, no, I just want to be a housewife, and I'm just a girl, and I want my husband to be the breadwinner, and I want to just not have to work, and my husband pay me to, you know, do whatever I do throughout my day, like, just be in good shape and all this kind of thing, and essentially be a housewife. And it's so interesting, though, because a lot of the women have changed their mind from being the strong, independent woman who doesn't need any man to, actually, hold on a minute, probably do want and need a man for a lot of things, like changing the tires on my car, or figuring out taxes for some women. I don't know, I'm just trying to think of arbitrary examples off the top of my head. Well, actually, no, they're not arbitrary, they're important examples. I need a man to, some women need a man to reach the top shelf, shit like that. And women are, I see it among a lot of women that I speak to nowadays, where they have done it, basically done a 180, where they've gone from the strong, independent woman to, I want to be a housewife and I want to be spoiled by a man who is a breadwinner, and so on and so forth. However, the messaging in the public arena is not changing along with that, at least not yet. I mean, I suppose it's still kind of, we're in a bit of a cultural reform nowadays, where people are actually starting to realize, hold on, all this bullshit that I've been talking for the last few years, all this kind of woke, modern, feminist, absolute trough of shit that I've been talking isn't actually what I want, and what I actually want is going back to the traditional ways of the past. I feel as though a lot of people are coming to that. Now, I'm sure there'll be plenty of people in the comments who are like, no, you're wrong. Men don't need women. Women don't need men. Blah, blah, blah. All this like divisive shit when it's actually like, hold on a minute. If you actually used your intellect and your IQ that you claim to have in such abundance, you would realize that the best and most optimal, most efficient, most effective combination is man plus woman combined. Now, argue that in the comments if you want. Sure, and a lot of the argument, it's funny because a lot of the arguments will just be based on like whether or not your parents divorced, or you know, whether you've had good relationships in the past or whatever like that. So they're kind of silly arguments anyways. But getting back to the point, which is it has become so widespread now to this kind of message where it's like, it's humorous. Like, that is a humorous message, you know, men to the left because women are always right. That's humor. Like, I guess that is funny. However, when it's in the public space, like literally the public toilets in my city, think about all the young children, like young men and young women. It's pertinent to both men and women, but especially to the young men, I think, because, well, then again, it's not even especially to the young men, because for the young men seeing it, it's kind of, the more they see that, the more degrading it is to their self-esteem and their sense of masculinity and their sense of worthiness. Because, bro, literally, the more I saw that message when I was like 11 in that restaurant, because I used to go there a lot with my family, the more I saw that, the more I started to, first of all, actually start resenting women and femininity and the beauty that women are, like the amazing existence of women. But second of all, it also started to have an impact on my self-esteem and an impact on my sense of worth being I wasn't a man at that stage, obviously I was only 11, but my future goals of becoming a man. And genuinely, the more I saw it, the more I was like conditioned to believe, oh shit, like I'm probably wrong. Now, drop a comment below saying, you know, that's just fragile masculinity and you need to be more resilient and all that kind of thing. But I'm not just talking about a one-off experience. I'm not just talking about like, you know, some 8-year-old young man sees that message once and then his whole world is rocked. I'm not talking about that. But what I am talking about is repeated messaging. And I will prove the point that I'm making here. So my point is that the more someone sees that message, especially a young man sees that message, the more he will start to believe it. And straight away, you might try and argue that in the comments, but let me fucking dismantle your argument with one simple statement. The McDonald's jingle. It's playing in your head right now, isn't it? I know for a fact you're hearing the
da 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 da, I'm loving it.
I know that is playing in your mind right now. The McDonald's jingle is literally playing in your mind. And you know why that is? It's not because it's unbelievably catchy. It's not because you really like the jingle. It's not because you really like McDonald's. It's not because you had McDonald's yesterday because you're a fat fuck. It's not because McDonald's are some like absolute geniuses who hacked the sound waves and the frequencies so that that jingle would stick in your head. Do you know why you could instantly remember the McDonald's jingle? Is because of repeated conditioning messaging. You have heard the McDonald's jingle so many times that like literally just clicking your fingers, it will play out in your head. I know for a fact you remember what the McDonald's jingle sounds like, even though you mightn't have heard it in years. I haven't heard the McDonald's jingle in years, probably a decade. I don't watch TV. I genuinely haven't sat down and watched TV, you know, like where the ads are in, God, fucking at least 5 years. It's been a very, very long time. But yet, the McDonald's jingle is so front of mind, not front of mind as in I'm always thinking about it, but I can call it to my memory instantly. And that is the point I am making with this messaging, this feminist, like, men to the left because women are always right. Like, to me, that's like the extreme. And I don't mean to shit on, you know, like intersectional feminism or healthy feminism, whatever that is, whatever your definition of it is. I'm talking about like the extreme version of feminism where it's like, no, women don't need men and we should kill all men and fuck all men. We'll figure out how to like reproduce so that we don't need men anymore. And like, I've seen that online, and a lot of the time it's from absolute radical weirdos. Like, it's absolute creepy women who couldn't even like get a man if they wanted to. Or it's from the men who Jordan Peterson talks about this a lot, and it makes me laugh so much, but the men who are like, they saddle up with the women because, and you know why they do that. Like, if you know a man who is an extreme feminist, you know why he's doing that is because he wants to get inside your panties. I'm telling you that right now. If he is like, you know, like quoting like I don't even know any feminists to off the top of my head, but if he's like, you know, a real ally of the whole feminist movement and all that kind of shit, you know, it's just because he wants to get in your pants. Like, I'm telling you that right now. I'll save you like a lot of creepy interactions from these kind of men who are like extreme radical feminists who are just saddling up to women. But anyways, getting back to the point and my issue with this message is that it has become so widespread that it's like you can call to mind that message. And the more you see that message, the more it gets implanted in your brain and the more you start to believe it. It's kind of like what I've talked about in previous videos is faking confidence until you become confident. Like, I genuinely became confident in myself because I used to do these affirmations and repeat, like, I am confident, I am strong, I am cool. All these like cringy fucking affirmations. But you know what? Over time, I started to believe them. And especially when I acted them out, I started to believe them and they started to just become who I am. And now I am a confident individual. I'm going to open the door because it's kind of hot as balls in here, but that is the point I'm making, is that the more that message becomes widespread, the more people are going to start to believe it, even though it's not fucking true. Like, men to the left because women are always right. I mean, first of all, we know that's just objectively not true. Like, that's just an objective falsity. However, even the like the subtle tone of arrogance or disdain towards women, disdain towards men, sorry. The underlying tone is so dangerous. That is what actually makes the difference. It's not the like the blatant, like, this is clearly a joke, this is clearly just like, you know, we're just saying this and it's just women being just women and all this kind of shit. Like, if this is actually a problem, I'm telling you right now, the more that message gets stuck in people's head, the worse society will become. Because the truth of it is, neither women nor men are always right. People in general are generally wrong. People are most of the time wrong about the opinion they have. And I could be completely wrong about this, what I'm talking about in this video for the last like 18 minutes. I could be completely wrong. However, I can't deny it anymore that, first of all, it's a fucked up message, because it's like, why are we putting this in, first of all, young men's heads, like, deteriorating their self-esteem and their sense of worth as a man? But second of all, why are we putting it in young women's heads? Why are we making them think that, oh yeah, no, men are always wrong and I'm always right? How could that translate into a healthy society and a healthy culture? It can't, because that sense, that belief that you're always right is probably the worst thing you can have. It's probably like the biggest hindrance to anyone's development and growth is to think that they are always right. And I have been so guilty of this past. I've been so guilty of thinking I'm always right and thinking I know how to live life the best way and, oh, this is what I should do for the rest of my life. I've thought that so many times, and every single time, life has slapped me in the face for thinking that. So I suppose maybe I'm doing the exact same thing that I just said by making this argument. But one thing I know to be true is the impact of repeated messaging, and like it's almost subliminal in a way. I mean, it's overt, but it's the message is overt, but the effect of that message is very subliminal, very subconscious, very like. I almost sound like a conspiracy theorist making this video, and I'm really not. Like, I really don't follow conspiracy theories. I think they're like essentially what losers do to fill their time up with something that isn't just completely, like, utterly detrimental to their lives. So I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but I know, like, I've studied marketing. I have a master's degree in marketing, and one of the strongest ways to get your message out is simple repetition, simple conditioning. Like, think about what was that guy's name? The guy who did the experiment with the dogs where he like made them salivate. This is kind of the same thing, where he trained them to believe that by the ringing of a bell they were about to get fed, and it therefore would make them salivate, even though just from ringing the bell, even though there was no food present. And that's kind of a similar thing, or it's like an analogy, because that is a result that proves how impactful conditioning is. And like, if you are naive enough to think that only works on dogs, you have a lot of learning to do, my guy. Like, you have a lot of waking up to do. You really, really do. And I can speak to this literally from a master's degree in marketing point of view. Like, I'm not just saying this as in, you know, this is just my opinion. I'm saying one of the core fundamental methods or strategies in marketing is repetition. Message repetition is so impactful. You don't have any idea. And literally, the McDonald's jingle proves that, bro. If you don't believe me, just fucking think of the McDonald's jingle. You know it. You already know it because you've heard it so many times. And the same thing probably is already happening, but will definitely happen the more widespread this message becomes. And I suppose maybe this video is kind of obsolete, because there's nothing I can specifically do to deter that message from being spread. However, I believe that one of the best ways to combat a message that is toxic and hurtful and degenerative over a long period of time is to start your own message and invite others to align with your message and with your beliefs and so on and so forth, which is why I've made this YouTube channel, is to invite you who's watching this video right now, because I know you've watched this far into the video, and credit to you for doing that, because, you know, it's a lot easier to just watch TikToks or Reels or YouTube Shorts and so on. So credits to you for sticking around for this long. And if you kind of have a resentment towards that message, I urge you to press subscribe, because what I promote on my YouTube channel is not the opposite of that, as in women to the left because men are always right. I don't promote that at all. Like, both genders can be right and both genders can be wrong, depending on a myriad of different things. However, the message that I promote is men, women combined is like the fucking best example of life. It's the best thing we can ever hope for as humans that have two genders, is the combination of both. And like, you might be a young man who's kind of like anti-women right now, and that's okay. I mean, we all kind of have to go through that phase where we disdain like the opposite gender, or we disdain our parents, or we disdain teachers, or we disdain our peer group in order to go through some sort of growth in some aspect of life. However, please don't forget that what women can bring to the table plus what men can bring to the table is beautiful when it's combined correctly. And a big part of my goal with this YouTube channel is to highlight and show the ways in which men and women combined as like a unified force can be magnificent, like incredible. I'm telling you that for a fact, and I will prove that as time goes on. You just have to stick with me. So if you disagree with this kind of like divisive, toxic, inflammatory message that like men to the left because women are always right, if you disagree with that and you actually are like, hold on a minute, probably this guy is right because like men and women together could be incredible if we actually learned how to coexist, please press subscribe. Please drop any comments below. I don't care if you disagree, if you agree, if you're indifferent. I want to hear from the people watching this video because I imagine this might get quite a few clicks because it's, you know, it's one of those topics that, I mean, it's a classic topic, but it's also trending as well. So I want to hear from you. And I don't want to hear like, I don't want comments where it's people being like, oh no, you're an idiot for thinking this and I'm so much more intelligent than you and all this kind of thing. Like, save the fucking vanity, save the ego, save the like sinful pride in your intellect. And actually, if you're going to disagree with my argument, actually dismantle it without the passive aggression, without the angry like subliminal tone, without all the fucking weird shit that people do online. Actually have a conversation in the comments. I would love to see conversation in the comments rather than argument. Yes, debate, like debate if you want to, go for it. And I will debate. I'm planning on replying to as many comments as this video gets. But yeah, both genders should go to the left because neither gender is always right. Honestly, honestly. I'm gonna leave it there, bro, because that's all that I've got for today. So, until next time, bro.